show business, like no business I know. All made up and soon you'll be appearing. Every bit of nervousness is gone, and the sound that's music to your hearing, to hear them cheering when you come on. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. How I wish the folks at home could only see what's come to end.
On with the show it is, as it's another edition of Cindy Predicts the Oscars. Now, Cindy has seen every picture up for all the major awards, and she's going to put her flawless record on the line. But brace yourselves. Cindy shoots from the hip, and she's hip when she shoots. So, without further ado, let's get to our first category, Actress in a Supporting Role. Cindy, your thoughts on this crop of nominees.
You know, I think there's some hits and misses in this group.
First off, there's Patricia Arquette as a single mother in Boyhood.
You know, she's getting a lot of recognition, but I truly think they're giving it because this was a movie filmed over 12 years.
Laura Dern, a single mother with challenges in Wild.
This was a heartbreaking, authentic performance.
Keira Knightley plays a math prodigy in The Imitation Game.
You know, this was really more of a lead character.
Emma Stone as the disenfranchised daughter in Birdman.
You know, I think her character kind of gets lost in a bunch of other performances in this movie.
Meryl Streep as the witch, Into the Woods.
It's Meryl Streep. Always a very professional performance.
So there you are. There are nominees. But Cindy, was there a performance in this category you thought maybe was snubbed this year?
You know, I think in the movie Gone Girl, Carrie Coon plays Ben Affleck's sister, and she was really the moral center of this movie.
So Carrie Coon is snubbed. Of the nominees, who do you think should win?
I think it should go to Laura Dern, who portrays the movie or the mother in Wild.
And should is not will. And this is Cindy Predicts the Oscars. Cindy, who will win the Oscar for Best Actress?
I think they're going to give it to Patricia Arquette.
Patricia Arquette, mark it down, Cindy Predicts, and we'll move on to our next category, and that is Best Supporting Actor. Your thoughts on this crop?
You know, I think in this group, there was really only one memorable performance.
Nominees are Robert Duvall as the crusty old judge in The Judge.
You know, I think this was a really tired performance in a rather poor movie.
Ethan Hawke plays the father in Boyhood.
You know, he plays Ethan Hawke for all 12 years.
Edward Norton is a temperamental actor in Birdman.
I'll have to say, he does have one mind-blowing scene in this movie.
Mark Ruffalo plays wrestler David Schultz in Foxcatcher.
He's the best part of a rather dreary film.
And J.K. Simmons as the conductor of the studio orchestra in a New York conservatory.
He's brilliant in this role. It was my easiest pick in years.
So thus are the nominees. But Cindy, was there a performance you thought snubbed in this category this year?
Yes, in the movie Unbroken, the man who plays the bird, Taasmahasha Ishihara, he had a very cruel, insecure character he had to portray, and he was very, very evil.
So there's your snub. In this category of the nominees, who should win?
Oh, it should definitely go to J.K. Simmons in Whiplash.
J.K. should win. Cindy Predicts the Oscars. Who will win Best Supporting Actor?
I'll be shocked if they don't pick J.K. Simmons.
So J.K. Simmons, mark it down, your Best Supporting Actor for 2014. And we'll move on to our next category. And that's going to be Best Actress. Cindy, your thought on this crop of nominees?
I think these were really strong performances. All of them were deserving of their nomination.
Let's meet them. Marion Cotillard plays a woman who's lobbying for her job in 2 Days, 1 Night.
She plays a very fragile character. She maintains this throughout the movie. It's a Belgian film. It was very difficult for us to go see this one.
And Felicity Jones as the wife of Stephen Hawking in The Theory of Everything.
You know, she was a very interesting character in this movie.
Julianne Moore plays a woman with early onset Alzheimer's in Still Alice.
You know, very frustrating to watch this movie, and they did not know how to end it.
Rosamund Pike as the conniving young bride in Gone Girl.
You know, she's such a beauty, and she was really chilling in this performance.
And Reese Witherspoon, a woman on a quest in Wild.
Boy, she was very believable in this physically demanding part.
A tight race, deserving nominees, but was there a performance in the lead category you thought snubbed for this year?
Yes, there was one other. I thought Emily Blunt in The Edge of Tomorrow, also a very physically demanding role, nothing like she's ever played before.
Emily Blunt snubbed. Of the nominees, who should win Best Actress?
Boy, I'd sure like to see it go to Rosamund Pike, in Gone Girl.
Rosamund Pike should win. Cindy predicts the Oscars. Who will win?
I predict that they're going to give it to Julianne Moore.
Julianne Moore, 5 nominations. This would be her first win. Mark it down, Cindy predicts. And we move on to the next category, Best Actor. Cindy, your thoughts on this crop of nominees?
Boy, this is also a very tight race.
Let's meet them. Steve Carell as billionaire John DuPont in Foxcatcher.
He goes through a very big physical transformation, unrecognizable in a very creepy role.
Bradley Cooper as sniper Chris Kyle in American Sniper.
This is his most authentic role to date.
Benedict Cumberbatch plays the man who cracks the Enigma code in The Imitation Game.
Boy, he's good in every role that he takes.
Michael Keaton, an actor attempting to redeem himself in Birdman.
You know, I really thought that this part and this role was a little bit over the top.
Finally, Eddie Redmayne as Stephen Hawking in The Theory of Everything.
Boy, this is a wonderful effort in a really difficult role.
So thus are your nominees. Do you think there was a performance out there that the Academy snubbed in this category?
Yes, there was a nice film called Nightcrawler, and it was Jake Gyllenhaal portrayed a really evil, kind of creepy character, but you were rooting for him the whole movie.
A performance that not only not nominated, probably would have won, or at least deserving so. Jake Gyllenhaal and Nightcrawler. So, there's your snub. Who do you think should win?
I think they should give it to Bradley Cooper. I think this is the best performance he's given in his entire career.
Bradley Cooper, an American Sniper, should win. But this is Cindy predicts the Oscars. Who will win?
I think the sentimental favorite, Michael Keaton, is going to win in this category.
Michael Keaton, a long distinguished career, wins his first Oscar for Birdman. Cindy predicts the Oscars. Okay, now we move on to the really big category, the Academy Award for Best Picture. Your overall thought on the crop of movies for 2014?
You know, it wasn't a very strong crop of movies. They were mediocre at best.
Let's move on to the nominees. Clint Eastwood's American Sniper.
You know, he did a really good job of depicting a true story.
A movie that appears to be shot in one long continuous take, Birdman.
Boy, this was a very complex movie. It was difficult to watch and really hard to follow.
Filmed over 12 years, Boyhood.
You know, I think they're giving a lot of credit to this movie because of filming over 12 years, but it was basically a memorable story.
And only from the mind of Wes Anderson, The Grand Budapest Hotel.
You know, this was a whimsical film. There were too many characters, and I think it was probably best suited to be like a TV series.
Okay, The Man Who Breaks the Code with the Secret, The Imitation Game.
Boy, this was a really worthwhile movie, if nothing else, so we would know the story behind this.
And Oprah Winfrey's Selma.
It was kind of a, you know, the same old formula used to show what happens during some kind of a movement.
Stephen Hawking's biography with a concentration on his marriage in The Theory of Everything.
You know, it was a movie about him, but we wanted to know more about her.
Behind the closed doors of the heavy competition in a New York conservatory, Whiplash.
This was a gripping and intense movie with very richly developed characters.
Okay, so those are the nominees, but does the nominations always translate to the best movie of the year? Cindy, in 2014, what was the best movie you saw?
You know, I think Whiplash was the best movie I saw.
Whiplash, Cindy's best movie of 2014. We move back now to the actual nominees. Cindy, of all of them, who do you think should win the Oscar?
Well, I think they should give it to Whiplash. It had the best performances, really richly developed characters, very unusual story that you haven't heard, and you know, a stronger movie than the other ones in this category.
Gripping, well-deserved movie, Whiplash, but this is Cindy Predicts the Oscars. Cindy, for 2014, who will win Best Picture?
I predict it's going to be The Theory of Everything.
Cindy thinks The Theory of Everything will be the Best Picture of 2014. You make your own predictions. I guess we'll find out because the Academy Awards are Sunday, February 22nd. Check out your predictions along with Cindy. We want to thank our sponsors.
See you next year.